Let us start with our seventh experiment, seven segment display with heat sensor. We begin here. Since we are using seven segment and heat sensor, we select seven segment display and heat sensor, which is nothing but, as you can see, temperature sensor. In our assembly screen, we connect these to B box. 7 segment will connect it to B and C port, and temperature sensor we shall connect it to A1. Now do the connections with your actual B box. Once you have finished with the connections, let us look at the logic flow. In the logic flow, we need to first determine what is the temperature sensor's value. So in order to determine, we need to first upload a dummy program. So we start and we click on repeat and then upload the program to B box. Now we'll check the sensor's value. As you can see, at the beginning, the OLED screen displays a value of 298. As I apply hot air on the sensor, the value starts increasing from 298 all the way up to greater than 450. Now that we have determined the sensor's value, let us start the project's programming. Let us start by clicking on begin. We select the same components as done earlier. 7 segment and the sensor, temperature sensor or heat sensor. Next, in the assembly phase, we connect the 7 segment to B and C port and the temperature sensor to A1 port. In the logic flow, as you saw in the sensor calibration video, we noticed that the heat sensor started from varying from 288 all the way up greater than 400-500 range. In this project, we will divide the sensor's value into three parts. First part in the range of 250 to 400. Second part in the range of 400 to 600. Third part in the range of 600 to 900. In these three parts, we will make the 7 segment display 0, 1 and 2 respectively. Let us start. Click on if. We will require two ifs. One to check whether it is greater than 250 and second to check whether it is less than 400. So we have two ifs, lastly an output and wait end if. The second if, we end the if. Next, we add one more if. So the same structure, add another if to it. Next, add an output, add a wait, end if. Add one more if, add one more if to this, output, wait, end if, repeat. So the entire program is divided into three parts, having three different if structures. So let us program. Starting with the first if, we'll check if A1 is less than 400, approximately, I'm getting it as 399. The second if, we check if A1 is greater than 250. Next, in the next if, we check whether A1 is less than 600. Next, in the second, next if below it, we check whether A1 is greater than 400. The next if structure, here we check whether A1 is less than 900. And lastly, we check whether A1 is greater than 600. So the if conditions are done. Now let us look at the output. Since you have connected 7 segment to B and C port, we need to use B1, B2, B3, B4, C1, C2, C3, C4. As you can see in this image, the 7 segment which is connected to B and C port, where each of the segments of the 7 segment are marked with their respective pins of B box. Now let us look into the programming part. Let us consider the first output. In the first output, we display the value of 0. For 0, we need to turn on B1, B2, B3, B4, C1 and C2. Rest of them, C3 and C4 should be 0. In the second output, we need to display the value of 1. So we need to turn on B2 and B3. In the last output, we need to display a value of 2. So here we need to turn on the ports B1, B2, B4, C1 and C3. Now let us look at the wait part. We will give 1 second each for every wait. Now the programming is done. You can click on save and save the program. We name it as experiment 7. Click on OK and upload the program to BBox. Once you have uploaded the program to BBox, as shown in this video, you notice that when the temperature sensor's value is in the first range, the 7 segment displays a value of 0. As I apply hot air using hair dryer, you notice that the temperature sensor's value increases slowly and gradually, and you will notice that the value of 7 segment display on 7 segment turns 1 and 2 respectively, depending on the amount of heat applied to the temperature sensor. At this point, the display is showing 1. As the temperature increases beyond 600, you will notice that the value has increased to 2. Now, if I remove the heat incident on the temperature sensor, you will notice that the sensor's value will start dropping, as well as the 7 segment value reduces to 1.